permits. I had a member statement today, and just to be brief, Mr. Chairman, we have a spending problem here in the province. We aren't doing our due diligence, planning in advance, and there are some things in here, like I say, the pine beetle devastation, the Slave Lake forest disaster. Those things are understandable, but there's just multiple other cases, Mr. Chairman, in the supplemental supply where this government has failed to plan adequately going forward. But the biggest part of what the plan needs to be is, are we going to strive and do all of our due diligence to balance our budget? We've got $850 million in spending in here for supplemental supply when we have a $6 billion cash deficit in our yearly budget. And it's critical that we look at these things and realize what is sustainable. We've got this rush saying we need to build all of these structures. We've got this infrastructure. We need to do it now, now, now. We're creating this huge need to build. And yet in 2-3 years from now, all of a sudden we're going to have no cash, and we can't spend $7 billion a year. It's going to contract down to probably 4 or less, maybe have to make a super contraction because of the amount of money that the government is spending each fiscal year. And it's just not in the best interest long-term for Albertans. We need to scrutinize the supplemental supply. I encourage the government as we go to recess for next spring that they really go through with a fine-tooth comb and say, what do we do so that we don't have these supplemental supplies next year? What do we do to balance our budget? We've got to do more. The Wild Rose is every encouragement, every idea that we can possible in areas where they can make cuts. And you know, we've got the $2 billion carbon capture, which the new premier now says, well, we're going to take $500 million of that out, but we're going to redirect it. It's not about reducing these things. And there's just case after case where the money is being spent, whereas what we should be is having a 3- or 5-year infrastructure plan saying, well, yes, that's on the priority list. It's number 7. We're going to spend $4 billion a year, and we're not sure whether it's going to be year 2 or year 3 or maybe year 4 before we get to that. But we need to prioritize. It's critical. We need to balance our budget. We see that the economic storms that are going on across the Atlantic in Europe, and this is all because of governments who aren't being fiscally responsible, and that's the problem with this supplemental supply. We're not doing our due diligence. We're not serious about the problem because we can just say, oh, it doesn't matter. We have our sustainability fund. The spending is not sustainable. They need to go through it and do a far better job of scrutinizing it. And next year, let's see supplemental supply only have emergency disasters and things that were beyond ability to forecast. Not such simple things as $15 million because we need more salt and gravel for our roads, which is just one of the ones that's somewhat amazing that's in the supplemental supply. But with that, Mr. Chairman, I'll sit down and see if anybody else wants to address the bill. Thank you.